Hello everyone, I'm Durga Sahani and we are creating a series of video tutorials for advanced MySQL concepts in PHP. In the previous session, we have seen how to create a stored procedure with parameters and without parameters. Now in this session, we are going to see how to use cursor in stored procedure. Okay. So what is cursor first? Cursor is like a pointer which will iterate on a result set of any other SQL. Okay. And it's a read only, it is not updatable. To use cursor, you have to follow these steps. So first one is declare cursor, then open cursor, fetch cursor into local variable, and then close cursor. Okay, so I have given the syntax over here. Let's see how we can do that, how we can create. So first go to the select your database, and let me first clear what I want to do with the cursor is, see, there is one tables books, and in these books there are one field sold by. So just I want to get to know which books are available on Amazon, list of the books which are available on Amazon or Snapdeal or Flipkart, likewise. Okay, so let's start. Select the database, go to the routines, click on this add routine. And we don't want any parameters, so remove it. I'm going to say get all books. Okay. Now first begin it and then end, and in between we have to write the all the commands. So first just declare some variables which we are going to use. Declare, let's say, book name and sold by as simply text, and then declare one more variable, or first declare the cursor. So for syntax of declaring cursor is this, right? And there should you write cursor name. So cursor name, let's say book underscore cursor, and here you have to specify the SQL. So I'm just going to say select name comma sold by from books table semicolon, and now open this cursor. After opening, we have to fetch and then close the cursor, right? Here we have to fetch, so just say fetch from cursor name into the variable name which we have created, like book name comma sold by, right? And just for printing purpose, you can use select and book name, but we have to print it only if this sold by is our condition. So say if this equal to Amazon, then only print this name, select this name, right? So and then end if and semicolon. So if you save this, just click on go. Now the cursor is created, get all books. If you execute it, you're getting this Raj Yoga, and if you go to the books, you can see it is sold by Amazon only. So you're getting is properly, but you're getting only one. So if you want to get multiple records, all the books, then you have to use loop. So for using loop, there is one syntax for it, and that is, let's say book underscore loop label and then use loop, and over here we want to close this loop. So just say end loop name label. Okay, but see, we have not yet written the logic for exiting this loop, so we need that thing. So I'm going to declare one more variable over here, is declare exit loop, and this one should be boolean type. You can specify default value false, but default is false only if you have not specified, so no need to write the default value. Or if you want, you can write default false. Okay, now we are going to declare one more handler. If this fetch will not return anything, in that case we have to exit the loop, right? So I'm going to just declare one more thing. So you can say declare and continue handler for not found, and in that case just set this exit loop equal to true. Okay, and we'll check one condition over here. After fetching this, we'll check one condition: if this is true, then just end this if, and here we'll say leave this loop. Simple. Okay, now just save it. We are done. See, if you are not right using this, then you have to write all these statements. Okay, just click on this execute. Now you can see you are getting all this data. See this, if you want to check two states, just go to the books and two states, it is available on Amazon only. So you're getting all the data which are available on Amazon. If you want to get it from Snapdeal, which are the books are available on Snapdeal, just go to the stored procedure, edit it and change this to I think it was small, so I was not able to, you are not able to see this, so I'm just increasing this browser side. Okay, so let's see. I'm just change this Snapdeal, and if I'm going to but I'm not getting that button, go. Okay, I'll paste this to description. If you click on this execute, now you're getting all the books which are available on Snapdeal. Okay, so this is a very simple example. So here let me open it into the new tab to explain you. Okay, see what we have did here is we have declared two variables, book name and sold by of text type. Then we have declared one exit loop of boolean type, default value is false. Then we have declared cursor of we are selecting data from name, book name and sold by from books table, and we have created this cursor. We have declared one handler for exiting this loop. Then we have opened the cursor. Then this is the loop label. We have started loop. We are trying to fetch a single row, as we know that cursor is work with the current set, so it will return the current set into the this first book name and sold by. Then we are checking one condition: if it is not returning anything, that's mean it is true, so it will, then we are going just leaving this loop, else it will not go inside. And here it will check whether this sold by is Snapdeal, then go here and print this name, book name. Okay, and here if everything is done successfully, and after that it will at the last it will return. So just close this loop, and we are closing this cursor. Okay, So this is a very simple example of using cursor, and there are so many way, there are so many complex SQL you can build in this stored procedure by using cursor and use it. So I hope you understand what is cursor and how you can use it in stored procedure. And one more thing, cursor you can use only in stored procedure in MySQL. Okay. So that's all about cursor. In the next session, I will show you how to create triggers and how to use it. So thank you very much guys for watching. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.